Now, new revelations on doping in sports and the fallout for one of America's best track and field runners. The 30-year-old American sprinter Tyson Gay was off to a great start this season after being plagued by injuries in recent years. But on Friday, the U.S. anti-doping agency, USADA, notified Gay that he'd tested positive for an unnamed banned substance in May. Gay broke the news himself yesterday. In an Associated Press telephone interview, he said, "I don't have a sabotage story. I don't have any lies. I basically put my trust in someone, and I was let down." It was quite an admission from the former world champion, who previously subjected himself to enhanced drug testing as part of USADA's My Victory program. Gay talked about competing clean during a My Victory promotional video in 2008. Gay's is the biggest U.S. track name linked to doping since Marion Jones tearfully admitted in 2007 to using performance-enhancing drugs.
"And so it is with a great amount of shame that I stand before you and tell you that I have betrayed your trust."
It was also reported this weekend that five Jamaican athletes have failed drug tests, including Asafa Powell, a former world record holder in the 100-meter dash, and Sharon Simpson, an Olympic relay gold medalist. Last month, another Jamaican gold medalist, Veronica Campbell-Brown, tested positive as well. All three have denied cheating. As for Tyson Gay, he's withdrawn from next month's World Championships in Moscow, and today he lost his Adidas endorsement deal. For more about Tyson Gay and the issues this raises, we are joined by Christine Brennan, a sports journalist and columnist for USA Today and ABC. Welcome back.
Thanks, Gwen.
So how big a blow is this to track and field?
Oh, I think it's huge. You know, Tyson Gay was known as Mr. Clean. This is the man who went on the U.S. Anti-Doping Agency website, Gwen, and said, "I am clean. If I'm not, my mother will kill me." Well, mom is not happy today, obviously. He went and professed that he is one of the athletes to trust and believe in. He's 30 years old. His whole career has been about this. And now he has tested positive. It is a devastating blow for the sport, a sport that's already been reeling over the years from Ben Johnson in 88, Marion Jones 10 years ago, and now this. And you really wonder if it's kind of taking and pushing the sport into oblivion.
How about U.S. track and field in particular? I want to separate that out from what we also heard has happened with Jamaican runners.
Right. Well, USA track and field has really never been the same after some of the scandals, even though Ben Johnson was Canadian. But you can remember the days, sports fans certainly can, when track and field athletes would be on the cover of Sports Illustrated three, four, five times a year. You know, the names Marty Lacoury and Jim Ryan, milers, you know, the Penn relays were a big deal. This is lore and legend of another generation, but this was really, it's a big-time sport. And it has fallen so far, and I think it's really, other than cycling, a sport that has been hit the hardest in the United States and around the world, but U.S., because of the steroid scandals. You know, if you're looking at a foot race, and if you can't trust eight men or eight women running in a foot race, what can you trust, and then why should you watch?
Well, you mentioned cycling. How does this compare to what we saw unfold slowly, painfully over years with Lance Armstrong?
Great question. Obviously, different issues, because here you've got the one huge name, Lance Armstrong,
right,
who lied for years, who also transcended his sport because of his work in the cancer community. So he was an icon, a cultural icon, not just a sports icon. Tyson Gay is not that, is not Lance Armstrong. But I think that it's there's a similarity there. People looking at cycling and saying, "Why am I watching this? How can I trust this when you've got all those years of, and when Lance is kicked out and no one can take the top spot because they all cheated too?" And you almost wonder if track and field is there.
What is the punishment for Tyson Gay?
If he is found to be guilty, a 2-year ban, and then it would be lifetime after that. So first offense, 2 years, and second. Now, there can be mitigating circumstances, and we don't yet know if there was a supplement that was tainted. But the bottom line is he's responsible for what's in his body.
And has said as much. He has said he's not going to lie about this.
And that is admirable. In the midst of this terrible turn of events for him and for his sport, he has been honest and said, at least we believe he's honest, saying, hey, I'm not going to point fingers. I'm not going to say I was sabotaged. I did this myself. I trusted someone. Bottom line on Tyson Gay or any athlete, Gwen, is they have to know what they put in their body. It is inexcusable to take a substance and not know the contents. You can call the 24/7 800 number from the U.S. Anti-Doping Agency and ask about any chemical at any point.
You cover a lot of these sports, Chris, and you must know after all the years of watching these people rise and the disappointments that a lot of sports fans look at this and think, who do I trust? What do I trust anymore? Mm-hmm. What is the answer to that question?
It's a great question because the testing in the Olympic world is the toughest going. So while we talk about baseball and the problems there and looming scandal and looming suspensions with the biogenesis saga there, we talk about other sports that don't even have as stringent testing as the Olympics or baseball. You say, well, at least the Olympics has tough testing. And then you see this. So, and the reality is Marion Jones never failed the drug test, and she's sadly one of the worst cheaters of all time. Lance Armstrong never failed the drug test. So it's hard to look people in the eye and say, what can you trust anymore? I would like to say swimming. I would like to say you could trust Missy Franklin. You could trust Michael Phelps. But we all know, as we live here, we weren't born yesterday, that you start to wonder, I'm not saying Michael Phelps or Missy Franklin, but you start to wonder about anything just because of the nature, the level. Bad chemists, Gwen, are way ahead of the good chemist in this case.
So business as usual now for elite athletes to dope?
You know, it seems like the, as I said, bad chemists way ahead of the good chemists, the sense that there's designer drugs that we haven't heard of, that the authorities haven't even begun to test for because they don't know they exist, that these athletes might be taking. It's a very sad, this is a devastating blow when Mr. Clean, the guy who stood up there and said, I am clean, is now, has tested positive, and the Jamaicans as well. So I'd like to say there's some positive aspects or hope, but tougher drug testing has to be the answer, and athletes who finally decide they can't cheat anymore.
So disappointing.
It is.
Christine Brennan, USA Today and ABC, thank you so much.
Gwen, thank you.